Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix. Today we have a couple of James Bond movie posters to show you being linen-backed. The first one is a U.S. one-sheet poster for Dr. No, starring Sean Connery. And the second one is a French Grande, Roger Moore, For Your Eyes Only. So take a look what we did to restore these two 007 posters. Watch. I have been linen backing today, but I've left this space open so that I can put this one sheet poster for Dr. No. As you can see, it's got a few light horizontal creases. They're not heavy creases, and they're only horizontal ones. So I'm going to turn it upside down so that I can apply the wheat paste directly to the poster. Dr. No is a 1962 spy film directed by Terence Young. It is the first film in the James Bond series, starring Sean Connery, Ursula Andress, Joseph Weissman, and Jack Lord. It was adapted by Richard Maybaum, Joanna Harwood, and Berkeley Mather from the 1958 novel of the same name by Ian Fleming. Produced on a low budget, Dr. No was a financial success. While the film received a mixed critical reaction upon release, it has gained a reputation over time as one of the series' best installments. Dr. No also launched a genre of secret agent films that flourished in the 1960s. Many aspects of a typical James Bond film were established in Dr. No. The film begins with an introduction to the character through the view of a gun barrel and a highly stylized main title sequence, both of which were created by Maurice Binder. It also introduced the iconic theme music. Production designer Ken Adam established an elaborate visual style that is one of the hallmarks of the film series. And now, using a sponge, I'm going to wash off the face of the poster to make sure that there is no wheat paste. Came to me folded. The customer brought it to me in person so he could talk it over with me. I noticed that there's tape on the back. There's scotch tape on this seam, which probably means there's rips in the folds. I already see there's rips in the folds. See? And there's a rip here as well. Let's open it up. All right, what a beauty. Break in the fold there. Breaks there, although the paper looks like it's rolled so that when it's linen backed, it may come out and come together. Let's look at the back. Tape. For Your Eyes Only is a 1981 spy film directed by John Glenn in his first feature directorial debut. Produced by Albert Broccoli, the film stars Roger Moore as the fictional M16 agent James Bond and co-stars Carol Bouquet.
This is from Wikipedia.
The 12th film in the James Bond franchise produced by Eon Productions. For Your Eyes Only was written by Richard Maybaum and Michael G. Wilson. After the science fiction-focused Moonraker, the producers wanted to return to the style of the early Bond films and the works of 007 creator Ian Fleming. For Your Eyes Only followed a grittier, more realistic approach and a narrative theme of revenge,
and its consequences rather than the fantasy narrative of Moonraker. Filming locations including Greece, Italy, and England, while underwater footage was shot in the Bahamas. Scottish singer Sheena Easton performed the title theme song. For Your Eyes Only was released in the UK on the 24th of June 1981 and in the US 2 days later. It received a mixed to positive critical reception. The film's reputation has improved over time, with reviewers praising the more serious tone in comparison to previous entries in the series.
I'm pulling the poster with my hand because the poster has been expanding when it absorbs the wheat paste, and that makes the creases come up, so I need to stretch it out to make sure it's flat, and then roll it into its stretched position.
The film was a financial success, generating $195.3 million worldwide. This was the final Bond film to be distributed solely by United Artists. The company was absorbed by MGM soon after the film's release. What did Sean Connery really think about Roger Moore and his interpretation of 007? After Sean Connery had completed Diamonds Are Forever in 1971 and stepped aside from the role that turned him into a global star, he remained notably reluctant to comment on his successor in the role and on Roger Moore's version of James Bond. This was not surprising, as Sean Connery and Roger Moore had known each other since the early 60s and were good friends. Connery had also become disenchanted with the role of 007, fearing he had become typecast in an iconic role. There had also been tensions with the EON producers over money, with Connery feeling he had not been given the full share of what he was entitled to. As far as Connery was concerned, his time as Bond was now finally in the past, firmly in the past, and he had moved on to fresh acting challenges. However, as the 70s progressed and Connery gradually warmed to the idea of his own possible return to the role in an independent, non-EON Bond movie, this scrupulous diplomacy concerning the direction of the official 007 movies was slowly cast aside. Remaining careful not to make any personal comments on his friend Roger Moore, Connery nevertheless had very strong views on how he saw the character of James Bond and what he felt the official series now lacked. A good example came in 1981. At the time, Sean Connery had been increasingly linked to producer Kevin McClory's proposed independent remake of Thunderball, at that stage titled Warhead.
So we've got For Your Eyes Only linen-backed.
And Dr. No is linen-backed as well, and we've got to let them both dry for a few days.
You know, a lot of people have been visiting PosterFix lately, bringing their posters to me in person and discussing what needs to be done in their restoration. If you would like to do that as well, if it's convenient for you and you're in the area, you can set up an appointment with me so that I can send you the proper Brooklyn Navy Yard security credentials. Get in touch with me and we'll arrange it. We'll be right back. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. I hope you enjoyed watching me linen back and restore these vintage James Bond posters. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, you can send me an email to the address on the screen. Tell me something about your posters. Tell me their size, condition. Send me a few photos, and I can get back to you with a price for a restoration, and then you can ship them to me if you can't visit me in person. Until that time, I look forward to seeing your posters. Thank you. We'll be right back.